Good morning, day 195 in our series 2 to 5, and this morning has been all about color correction. Yes, exciting stuff. Kind of full circle color correction. Sometimes you gotta kind of step away from it and then step back to it, because I don't know that I really got a whole lot accomplished this morning. I was working on one particular scene where there's several different angles. There's a two shot, and then an over the shoulder, and over the shoulder, and you've got light that's coming in from all different directions. That just changes the sort of color palette depending on the shot that you're looking at. And I don't know if maybe it's early. I mean, I know it's early, but maybe it's because it's early. I have messed with these things too many times and have ended up very, very close to where I started, with just some slight adjustments in there. And I think that's probably the deal with me is, I usually make adjustments and make them probably too radical to begin with, just because I want to see like the change. Like if I'm adjusting, say, midtones, for example, I want to adjust it enough to where I go, okay, what is this affecting, right? Or if I'm doing like saturation, I want to see like if I take 50% of the saturation out, what is that going to do to it? And what I end up doing, yeah, still the voice thing. What I end up doing is doing too much, and then. Just taking the color correction completely off and go, well, is it fine the way it is? And then I start to go back and do like the real subtle adjustments, which from what I've seen online, like these guys online that know what they're doing, start off with the little adjustments in there. So I'm kind of doing it bass-ackwards, which is typical, just going too much and then dialing it back to where it is probably where they would end up, but they're able to do it, you know, go straight to it. And so, like I said, I did make some small adjustments, but it feels like very close to where I started. And but I like the way it looks now, which I didn't before, so I guess that's good. Went way over already this morning, but I'm gonna bounce over and do some writing and then call it a day. Alright, just wrapping up the writing this morning. I've went way over, so actually there's rumblings of people actually being up in the house. So if you hear something in the background, you'll know why. I have attempted to record this last video about 30 times because there continues to be gruntings and groanings and snortings and televisions and dogs coming by. So I've given up trying to record it without background noise. So I'm just going to hopefully talk in a steady stream, and you won't be too awfully interrupted by all the things that are going on in the background, like I am and can hear them going on right now. This is bad when you're editing stuff and you're used to like quiet or layering in your own sounds, and you just want to yell quiet on the set. But it's not a set, it's your house, and people are awake. So if nothing else, maybe this clip will be entertaining as I try to navigate this. But anyway, yeah, I'm just finishing up the writing. God. And finishing off my voice, Aaron Sorkin had mentioned, and I've said this in one of my other videos, that when you look at a scene and you look at characters, you have to, in order to create drama, you need to look at what their intention is and look what their obstacles are. They need to have a clear intention of what they want in the scene, and they need to have some formidable obstacles in order to, like, overcome them, and that combination is what creates the drama. So that's really what I was looking at this morning, the scene that I'm working on. The main character in the scene, I know what her intention is, and I know what her obstacles are, but I've got this support character in there, so I was just trying to brainstorm, like, what her intention is in the scene. And this is, I mean, really basic stuff, but it's good to be reminded. Like, what is she after? Because the way I have it written now, like, or the way I'm thinking now, she's just sort of in a support role. And no real clear motives. She's just kind of there for the main character. But I think it's good for us to sort of remember that even though we consider certain characters support characters, like, they still have motivations and should have obstacles as well. They shouldn't just be, you know, sort of there to bolster up the main character. Like, they have their own objectives too. So it's just a good reminder, and something that I'm trying to you know, sharpen up a little bit or shore up a little bit, so that we have some good drama created in each of these scenes, even if it is a comedy. So anyway, I'm wrapping this up before these noises in the background drive me crazy and you guys witness a murder on here. So I'll see you tomorrow.